today. I got some bangers. I got some prison TikTok moments. The beginning one is a conga line with the inmates on the block. And we're going to laugh today. We're going to have some fun. I'm going to check out these prison TikTokers. As I say, you're locked up. Give them a shout out. Tell them, hey, show them much love. They're in there. They're alone. They are around a bunch of males. So, you know, you see anyone you like, reach out. It just takes a letter. All right, let's get into it, baby. That man has some bomb shorts. You see those shorts? Oh my gosh. Where are you locked up? You get these gray tan shorts. Oh my gosh. That's crazy. Those are nice. Hit the sig.
It's not easy being the disappointment of the family, but here the fuck I am. Gang gang, bitch.
Boss.
That type of shit don't faze a player. This type of shit is what make a hater. We got it out of mud, yeah.
When they expect you to drink this shit.
That man is complaining about water, but he has a beautiful sink. That's like a porcelain sink. How did that man get a sink like that? Damn. Man, that's a beautiful sink. Oh my gosh. Playing about the water, got a beautiful sink.
This is a federal prison.
Gotta have the sausage, baby. People, real quick, how do inmates get cell phones? Quick question. I will answer that question, of course. We know this. It comes from guards or visits, and somehow they're able to sneak it in. But why would guards keep putting their lives on the line for a decent amount of money? A $50 cell phone, $100 cell phone can go for about $500 to $700 locked up. And then once a guard actually gets tricked or they make that choice to get in, inmates will actually grab together and blackmail this guard and basically say, we will actually tell on you unless you continue to carry stuff in. So in that point, the guard is stuck. If that guard stops carrying stuff in, she gets locked up, he gets locked up, and loses his job. So just a vicious cycle, people. But that is really how phones get into prison. Sad, man.
Sonny. This is real. This is your meal. On lockdown in the feds.
They did. They said no hot dogs. They said you can bologna sandwiches with a hot dog bun. Gotta save those taxpayer dollars. Did I spend the day in prison?
Life is just all about getting through the hard times, because they never will. Like, you know, sitting around crying is not going to change shit. So sometimes you just got to just wipe it with tears, man, and keep it going. Like, even gangsters cry, man, fuck it. But I'm going to be all right. I'm going to be home real soon. I got like 6 months left, man. I can't wait, man.
All right, where have I done jail time and prison time at? Because these people have some beautiful shirts, man. Oh my gosh, that man had like a top shot, the muscles with a freaking, could have been a V-neck. Oh my gosh, when do they allow this kind of shirts in there?
I don't know who needs to hear this, but there's literally inmates making TikToks. So sis, if he wanted to text you back, he would.
Oh,
off talking to. I'm a prisoner in my home. Ever told on a nigga? Nope.
What you guys just have seen and what you guys will see a lot is what we use is ramen noodles. Ramen noodles are the number one thing we use to create food because it's just, I don't know, just a perfect base can make a crust. So anything you see that has a pretty much like there had barbecue sauce and it, you can get pepperonis in there, but it looks like they're using sausage. That's what that creation was. Ramen noodles were underneath it.
Yeah. Ever set a nigga up? No. Ever helped a brother out when he was down on his luck? You were fat? No.
He throws his cards up.
You were mad? Oh. Yeah. Let me hold a couple dollars. No.
That's my sense of humor. My mistake was thinking that everyone was going to understand my joke. And,
Okay, people. Alright. When you are locked up and you are in prison and you're looking at time, a lot of people get locked up by people snitching. That stuff is not a joke. It is nothing to play around. That man deserved whatever he was coming from. We do not like snitches. I'ma get my shit and I come back. I'ma get my shit and I come back.
Guess who just woke up next to the love of their life this morning and just had sex? Not me, but good morning, though.
She told me put my heart in a bag. And nobody gets hurt. Now I'm running from the love. I'm not fast.
Oh, whatever.
So, Amber, you better be putting one on them just here.
Nah, motherfucker, you better not be messing around with no dudes in there.
That is different.
Prison one right behind her jail is exactly to a T, 100% instead of using the knife, but that is 100% correct. We use bags because we do not have anything to mixing, and we make a swole or a spread. That's basically meaning a bunch of people are going to put stuff together and eat, chopping up little things of sausage, pickle, cheese, ramen noodles. Use the bag, so you can get it all up and kind of cook it. And bam, you got to spread.
You've been asking me if working in a prison is how it's portrayed in the TV shows. No. However, what does happen at an alarming rate is staff getting fired for trafficking. I was shook when I had been there for only 2 months and there had been 4 staff walked out. Let's bringing see. In cell phones in the hoo-ha, trying to deal meth, coming to work on meth, passing out fentanyl, sleeping with the inmates.
Okay, so that girl, she may be working in a jail, but she is not seasoned. Again, I will explain this to you guys. It takes one time for a guard to make a mistake or know about the crime and not do anything. So if homeboy has 2 guys that are cool with, right, and or a girl, and she's down on her luck, because you got to remember, people that get hired here, they're just ordinary people. It's not like they have to go through a 6 to 8 week boot camp to bring in, to be a super cop. They believe they're super cops, but they're not. So once a girl that's friend with the other girls basically makes that mistake and brings something in to make a quick buck, $50 turns into $500, $700 to $1,000. It is 100% inmates and people will use blackmail, which is sad. They will talk the women into prostituting themselves to make money, sleeping with the inmates, bringing in drugs. Yes, some people do make this mistake and doing money, but from my time and my seeing it, was basically a guard would make a mistake, and when they would make that mistake, they were screwed. So all your guards and everyone that wants to make a quick buck, just be prepared, man. Kind of deserve it what's coming to you, but hey. Okay. did it. When that man was caught up, he said, screw everyone. I'm getting out. I'm doing mine. Did Snoop do it? That is a little flap that comes down is how when you're locked up and say you got to go on lockdown or basically it's a way for guards to send you through a little tray hole, your food, toiletries, anything. If you're in the hole, that's how you get fed or get anything you need. Or if you go. Gotta get those cheeks, run, boy.
Yo, what's up, Uncle?
Funny, right? He never said that he was done with his 10 years and might be booking it out of there, you know, flipping that bad boy off and he's gone, you know. But yeah, shout out, hopefully, dude. Seen this one. They used to be friends, so cool.
Yes, man.
Did you go to Nautilus for middle school?
Oh my goodness. Oh,
let me out.
Goodness.
Let me out.
I always wondered what happened to you, sir.
Let me out.
Oh my goodness.
Judge, we were best of friends. It's so great to see you. You say you're gonna let me out? I know you. My bond, I'm gonna get a PR bond, be out. You know, homeboy was putting up those waterworks to get out of jail. Dang, man, that dude thought he was like freaking throwing it. He had the freaking act, man. Crazy.
Making prison pizza. You'll need a Slim Jim,
okay.
Tomato sauce, one pack of ramen noodle,
yep.
One sleeve of Ritz crackers.
Yep.
Two sleeves of saltine crackers.
That's too many
crackers.
Who are
you calling a cracker? One block of cheese.
Yeah.
Thing of pepperoni.
Yeah.
A bag. All this has to be crushed down to a fine dust and put in the bag.
All right. Homeboy should know you have a hard time finding a bag. That's why people use actual trash bags and stuff to mix the stuff up. It's very hard to get a slip. Crazy, real quick. To get a bag that can basically Ziploc, can actually is known as a weapon. It can actually go over someone's head to kill them. So that's why bags are not allowed. Fun fact.
Boom. Add Slim Jims. Add
pepper. All right, y'all. Sorry, my son came in. My kiddos are needing me real quick. Love it. Prison TikTok. Couple things, not really too true. But yeah, like I said, remember, if you see any inmates you want to get a hold of, all they need to do is in the state or their TikTok, just look them up. Give them a shout out, man. They're alone in there, man, around a bunch of males. Would love someone just to talk to. So thank you, YouTube. Hope y'all are doing great. Peace out. Love y'all.